cities of the future that are really interesting to me now aren't really London, Paris, and New York. I mean, I think they've been compromised by this 30 years of neoliberalism, and to the extent that they're economically excluding so many people, so many groups of people who are traditionally the people who give the city its character, who give the city its culture, who give the city its kind of vibe, if you like. And to me, the more interesting cities that I've visited recently have been like Detroit and Barcelona, cities that are kind of emerging, that are kind of coming of age in this kind of increasingly kind of strange world that we're living in, a world where we're moving from kind of a capitalist, a more conceptualist mode of production. We're moving away from the idea that we can have paid wages and paid labour and we can have profit. So the whole basis of capitalism and socialism, as we traditionally understand it, are being undermined by these technological changes. So that presents fantastic opportunities for people to kind of to get together and to self-actualize and to find out what human potential is and what we can do as human beings. But it also presents a lot of threats as well, because we tend to, whenever there's a kind of massive changes and we don't quite understand them, we don't quite know where it's all going, we tend to retreat into the comfort of an imagined past. So we've had a kind of a Victorian pseudo-capitalism for 30 years, and now we have a kind of a nativist kind of pseudo-1930s sort of whole approach to policy. Again, it's like we need to kind of believe in cities. We need to have more power devolved to cities. We need to have more power devolved to local democracy. I think we do need to move back to the city-state. As Havens, as Antonio said, is same places against these kind of vagrancies of these kind of nationalist and globalist abuse of power. So basically, that's what I want to say. I want to kind of say yes for cities.